from the Chinese Loong to the Filipino Bakunawa, the Scottish Beithir to the Greek Hydra. Dragons have inflamed imaginations for millennia. Their ubiquity across world mythology has led many scholars to ponder their possible origins. Could it be that tales of dragons were crafted to make sense of violent weather events like storms or tornadoes? Did ancient peoples interpret volcanic eruptions or the unearthing of strange-looking bones as evidence that fire-breathing beasts lurked nearby? Questions like these are central to geomythology, which examines the connections between myths and the geology of the regions where they originated. It's based on the idea that legends are more than just fiction. They're also preserved records of the past. And these stories can contain valuable insights into our ancestors' understanding of the natural world. Beyond questioning the origins of mythical beasts like griffins, minotaurs, and dragons, geomythology can be a catalyst for scientific discovery. In Australia, for instance, researchers followed the clues in an ancient indigenous Dreamtime legend, which recounts a star falling into a waterhole, to locate a previously uncharted meteor impact site. And the field has also helped to correct geological timelines. Stories of Pele, the Hawaiian goddess of volcanoes, for example, led scientists to rethink the natural history of the Kilauea volcano. Following the events in the goddess's journey, they recalibrated when it's believed the volcano first collapsed, forming the vast, active caldera still present today. So what has geomythology uncovered about dragons? As far as we know, fire-breathing reptilian creatures never existed. And while it's unlikely that this diverse set of creatures shares a single origin, it's believed that some tales might be tied to the fossils of prehistoric animals. One such story is the Greek myth of Cadmus, who, according to legend, defeated a fierce water dragon and sowed its jagged teeth into soil. It's known that the remains of mastodons, including their large and pointy molars, are abundantly scattered across Europe. This has led some to suggest that ancient storytellers may have crafted Cadmus's tale after unearthing these mastodon fossils. Paleontologists have similarly dug up mastodon bones in Chios, a Greek island that was once said to have been terrorized by another jagged-toothed dragon. What's even more compelling is that the distinct physical features of dragons from different regions often mirror local fossil finds. The antlers of the auspicious and celebrated Chinese Loong may have been influenced by fossilized Pliocene deer skulls, which are commonly found in northern China. In the Shiwalik Hills of Pakistan, legends of dragons with unique jeweled crests may have been inspired by the calcite crystals often embedded in local fossils, such as the Civatherium, an extinct giraffe species. Other beastly characteristics like flame blowing may have been connected to geothermal features like volcanoes and hot springs. Take the chimera, a hybrid of a lion, goat, and dragon, supposedly originating in what's now Turkey. According to legend, the beast was slain by the hero Bellerophon, who thrust a block of lead into its fiery throat, choking it. Some scholars hypothesize that the fire-spitting natural gas vents in southern Turkey may have sparked stories of this flame-blowing beast. Similarly, the seemingly burnt landscapes of western Turkey, which are the result of ancient volcanic activity, could have stirred stories of the epic clash of Zeus and the hundred-headed Typhon. In fact, some tellings say the land itself was scorched by Zeus's bolts during their deadly duel. And more can be gleaned from dragon myths than just their possible origins. In China, paleontologists often plan digs in regions well known for their supposed dragon bone deposits. In fact, one of the richest areas in the world for finding dinosaur tracks is called Huanglanggo, which translates to Yellow Dragon Valley. So while these mythical beasts may never have prowled our caves, skies, or seas, their tales continue to be a source of inspiration, in both fantasy and science alike. Ready to keep learning? Watch these videos to either challenge what you think you know or learn more about what you don't. Subscribe and stay curious.